Brian Dolan, from the Kings and Terrace congregation. I want to be sort of like Brother Hope. Everybody knows Brother Hope's preaching, knows that he always, when he was ready to wrap things up, he always said, in my conclusion, and he always had three conclusions. So I want to start out by saying, in my conclusion, Phyllis Circle was correct when she said Brother Hope could not sing. Brother Hope, song, and one of them who took it was Well With My Soul. And he would always ask the song leader to lead the song, and then he would direct it. And when he gets to the end of this Well With My Soul, you know, he got to hold that note. Brother Hope, he'd be up there just like that. And people would start, you know, they'd run out of air. And would be so happy when Brother Hope would do like that. Also, Brother Hope, it was nothing to see him laboring around the church building. As I said, he thought he was a fixer-upper, but some of the things Brother Hope just could fix him here. Brother Hines, one of the elders, Brother Hines said that he knew that when everything was all right, GB would say, Lane. But then when he said, Hines, he knew he was in trouble. Brother Hines said that the Hope to him was like that. And the telephone calls that they often shared together, he was greatly missing them. In my conclusion, when I was thinking about Brother Hope in the office called me Steve, he said, Steve, he said, let's go. I said, where are we going? I got that from him also. He just grabbed a handful of cards from the Sunday service and he said, let's ride. And we jumped in that blue van. And I never rode with Brother Hope until then. And it was an experience riding with Brother Hope. Because he would, when he got ready to stop, he never would put his foot on the brake, you know, put it in gear and turn the motor off. He would just, as you approach the stop, he would just turn the motor off. And the car was going. I'm sitting there and I said, what's Brother doing? And he's fooling with the cars and the vehicle's still going. And then finally he hit the brake and threw it in here.
Jimmy Hope back in the summer of 1959 on the corner of Fried and Wade Street under a tent in the city of Valdosta. My initial impression was complete intimidation. On Monday night at the tent meeting. The next night I moved by five rows farther toward the rear of the building. But then along around Tuesday or Wednesday, I started listening seriously to his message. And here, 2 weeks had ended. I, along with approximately 53 others, had walked out and given our lives to Christ Jesus. And of course, the rest is history. I went off to the National Christian Institute that following fall. And since that time, I've passed across so many times. And then, of course, now living right here with us in the city of Dallas. We enjoy a lot of great moments. I concur with what Brother just said down to the whole family. Thank you for sharing with us.
As GB's endearing friend, Evangelist Clyde Muse, ascend to the podium to present the acclamation of his life.
I just want to say that Brandon was a howler. Powerful speaker. You saw that side of him every time he was in the pulpit. We saw it at home. There were times when we were out of line, he'd say, Carl! That's not what you're doing. So he was a powerful man. But I want you to know that he was a very soft, sad, soft side of man. Very, very soft side of him. He went all over the country preaching the gospel. had it not been for her, she would have been the man that it was. But he made a tape for my mother. And mom played this for this plant, this tape was for mother when he died. He wanted her and he wanted us to hear it. This is a different side, G.D. Cole. And mom talked about it and wanted to share this with you. It's old tape, it's got two or three spots in it, so it's going to be really hard to hear it. It gets louder as the time goes on. How important this, I have no clue. But it's beautiful, beautiful tape. It's a tribute to my mother. And I'd love you to hear it.
And you are. Here.